This tutorial is aimed to help you understand what it means to say that a point is a solution to an equation. An example of a problem you might come across a test looks like this. Is the point 2, 3 a solution to y equals 3x minus 3? In order to answer this question, it's going to help if we start by defining what does it mean to say that a point is a solution to an equation. A solution to an equation is an x-y pair, that is a number we're going to plug in for x and a number we're going to plug in for y, that makes the two sides of the equation be equal to each other. In other words, that makes the equation balance. So what the example problem above is really asking is, when we plug in 2 for x, because that's the x-coordinate of our original point, and 3 for y, because 3 is the y-coordinate of our original point, into this equation, does it make the two sides of this equation, y on the left and 3x minus 3 on the right, does it make those two sides of the equation be equal to each other? So let's work through this and see how we would answer this question with these specific numbers. The first thing we need to do is to rewrite our equation y equals 3x minus 3. What we're going to want to do is, in place of the x in this equation, we're going to replace it with the number 2. And in place of the y in this equation, we're going to replace it with the number 3. And the question is, does the equation that we get, is this true? Is 3 what you get when you multiply 3 times 2 and subtract 3? Let's work this through. 3 times 2 is 6. Minus 3. 6 minus 3 is indeed 3. So you can see that when I plugged in a 2 for x and a 3 for y, the two sides of the equation were in fact equal to each other. These two sides do balance. What does this mean? Well, this means that the point 2, 3 is the solution to the equation y equals 3x minus 3. That's what it means to say that a point is a solution to an equation. We found one solution to the equation y equals 3x minus 3, and that was the point 2, 3. I'm going to note that point in an xy table here. Notice that putting 2 in the x column and 3 in the y column is just another way of writing the point 2, 3. These two ways of representing this point are equivalent to each other. Next, I'm going to look and see if I can find some other solutions to this equation. So I'm going to ask, is the point 1, 0 a solution to y equals 3x minus 3? Again, I'll start by writing my equation y equals 3x minus 3, and I'll plug in a 1 for the x, and at the same time plug in a 0 for the y. And now I'm going to see if this equation balances. Is that true? Is 0 equal to 3 times 1 minus 3? Well, let's see. 3 times 1 is 3, and 3 minus 3 is 0. So when I plug in 1, 0 in this equation, it does indeed balance. That means that the point 1, 0 is also a solution to y.